If you landed on this video, you wonder yourself, should I go Scrum, should I go Kanban, or should I go Scrumban, because this seems really cool. In this video, I will work with you in a workshop way to decide which one is better for you. Grab your team together, let's all watch this video and do the exercises through the videos. So let's get started. Hi everyone, my name is Anka. I'm an Agile coach specialized in scaling Agile. And in this channel, I'm releasing educational videos about Agile every single Tuesday. So if you are new to this channel, feel free to subscribe and check out the other videos. All right, I was saying at the beginning of this video that I want you to get all your colleagues and we do a workshop together. When we are trying to decide whether to go Scrum, Kanban, Scrumban, or anything else, we need to see what is the problem that we are trying to resolve. I know a lot of teams that come to me and say, hey Anka, we want to implement Scale Agile in our teams, or we want to implement Scrum, but it doesn't really work. And that's not the way to get started. We need to get started with exactly your particular situation, with your particular problem, and find a solution that works for you. So, exercise number one, what is the problem that you are trying to resolve? Each one of you inside the team, make a list of the problems that you see right now in your team. They can be code related, that we have, we are not happy with the code quality. They can be deadlines related, they can be shareholders related. Anything you want, please express yourselves. And check out the description down below. I put tools that you can use for this. So make sure that everyone does a list, pause this video, and I will see you after. All right. Now that everyone put the ideas, show them, share them with everyone. If you use post-its, just gather along a whiteboard. If you use a digital board, just look at it. Each one of you, you are going to get two votes. And you are going to vote on the things that are the most important, the most urgent, the most severe, the ones that are really burning. Yes, that's an issue we need to fix right now. All right, now we voted, and most probably you have the topic, the hot topic. Take the first two ones and see which one are your problem. And I would really love to hear in the comments down below what are your main issues that you hope an Agile methodology is going to fix them. Now that you have your issues, I want to make sure that everyone is familiar with Scrum, Kanban, or Scrumban. In Scrum, the main principle is that we deliver value iteratively. We have precise moments for each subject. We have precise moments to plan, execute, demonstrate, retrospect, to improve. We are committing on a certain scope that we are going to deliver it in a certain amount of time all together as a team. We have as roles product owner who defines the functionalities of the product and is collaborating with the stakeholders. We have the development team that is making sure it's executing the scope. And we have the Scrum Master that is facilitating the meetings. And we have our stakeholders that whenever we are doing a demo, they can give us feedback about new functionalities, how they are using it. Kanban. Kanban refers also to deliver working incrementally. It's just that we have an ordered list of requirements, always the highest priority on top, and we pull as we go. We pull one, we make sure that we pass it through all the stages of development, it gets done, then we pick the next one, and we continue. The golden rule of Kanban is to limit work in progress. If you have a team of four, we have to make sure that we don't have more than 6 items or 8 items. Each one of you is important to define inside your team what is the limit of work in progress. This is key. If you don't limit the work in progress, Kanban, it's a completely chaos. You are going to have a lot of things started, but they don't go to the end to be released. And the way you measure it, like in Scrum, you do velocity, in Kanban, you have time to completion. It has to go as fast as possible from the beginning all the way to the end. In Kanban, we don't have a Scrum Master, we don't have a product owner, but we do have the daily stand-ups, we do have the demos towards our stakeholders, and we do have the retrospectives. It's up to the team to decide when to have them. Then it comes Scrumban. Imagine that you take Scrum and Kanban, and let's see what it comes up. Scrumban has iterations, but they are very small iterations. They are 1 to 2 weeks maximum. Because in Scrum, we can have iterations up to 3 weeks, 4 weeks, even more. But in Scrumban, they are very, very short. It's about making very small improvements and getting all the way to the customers and getting feedback. So we have the iterations from Scrum. We do have all the ceremonies from Scrum, like the planning, the daily, the sprint review, and the retrospective. And we take the limit work in progress from Kanban. So at any given time, we are allowed to take only a certain amount of issues inside one column. Our point, our goal is to take the tickets as fast as possible to the other side. While you are listening to me, you may think, I think I'm doing Scrum, but actually not Scrum. That is the case a lot of times. So please comment down below if you think you are doing actually Scrumban and not Scrum. What makes Scrumban very interesting is the part that we don't commit to a clear scope. Basically, we take an amount of tickets that we consider that we are going to do, and then we take them one by one, limiting the work in progress. It's very important. And we try to resolve them. Whenever we are done, we go for the sprint demo, then we do the retrospective, then we do the planning, and we take another set of tickets. And that makes it very fast to go through the flow. Now that we learn what are the three one of them very, very briefly, let's look on your needs and let's see the ones that correspond best. Scrum. If you have stakeholders that need to have predictability, if you need to work with more tools and not more administrations because of the synchronizations with other teams, if you think so, it's beneficial to have your planning meeting always at the same time and make sure that that's became very regular because we need this discipline and makes us be more productive, then go for Scrum. Then if you have a work that is the same process over and over again, maintenance, marketing, manufacturing, implementations like deliveries, all that, Kanban is the best deal for you, and you take the items one by one, you deliver them, and then whenever they are ready, you have a due date, you present it to your stakeholders, and you go ahead. And eventually you can do every Friday or every second Friday, you can have a retrospective meeting and see what you can improve. Or something very good that I've seen working very well on some teams is to have the retrospective at the end of every fifth ticket result or every 10 ticket result, something like that. Find your own balance. Scrumban. If you don't have any pressure for the management, and especially at the beginning when you just get started, like that we start more flexible, more light, we don't add a lot of unnecessary processes, so we don't need to wonder, so what do I have to do there? How does it affect it? We want to have the flow moving. We want to make sure that we deliver value and we don't get our work clogged with a lot of processes. So start with Scrumban, that's always my recommendation. And as you feel that you need to add more rules, keep on adding them and they have to make sense. Now put in the comments down below, which ones do you think that will resolve best your problems? And don't forget to subscribe to this channel, give it a thumbs up, share it with your colleagues and friends. And I will see you next week with another video.